Hey everyone, Vinayak here. Recently delving into 3D printing, I was looking for better ways to optimize the way I print. One important feature I wanted was a way to stop printing when a problem occurred. So here's where Octoprint comes in. So let's check it out.
3D printing takes hours. And if something goes wrong during a print, we have no way of knowing until we get near to the printer. With a 9-to-5 job, we set up the printer to print and leave for office, hoping that when we are back, we should have a ready print. I have set up an IP camera to monitor how the printing is going on, but I have no way of stopping the print when it misprints. A misprint also adds to wasted filament, which is not cheap in any way. Scouring the internet, I found Octoprint, a 3D printer interface which is accessible via a web application running on a Raspberry Pi. I have a Raspberry Pi, so why not set this up? Octoprint is free to download, so that's one obstacle removed. The app does need a Raspberry Pi to run, so if you have one, that's great, and I would recommend the Raspberry Pi 3. If you don't, there's a link in the description where you can pick up a kit. Octoprint also supports PiCam, a webcam module for the Raspberry Pi. It's not mandatory to have one, but if you don't have an IP cam to spare, it's a good add-on. Installation is easy. Download the image file off Octoprint website, extract the zip file to get access to the image file. You will need to download Etcher, an application that would clone the image onto your micro SD card, which would be used in your Raspberry Pi. You will then need to edit a file, octopiwpa-supplicant.txt, where you would enter the Wi-Fi credentials. Once done, insert the memory card into the Raspberry Pi. And now, when your Raspberry Pi is powered on, Octoprint starts up. A USB-A to mini-USB cable is required to connect the printer to the Raspberry Pi. I had connected the device to a TV so as to view any instructions, and it displayed a URL you would need to enter to access Octoprint via a browser. This was easy. On first start, you will need to configure a username and password, and as I kept all the settings to their defaults, hit next until done. Now we are on the Octoprint dashboard. Not changing anything on the connection settings, just hit connect and we should now have access to the printer. We now have real-time readings of the temperature of the printer bed and extruder as visible here. We can see the state of the printer, if it's printing, ready to print, etc. The files section allows loading up models and sending it directly to the printer. Let's upload a file to print. I have a PS2 model here, upload, and it's on the printer. We now have access to options next to the file name to download the file back to the system, delete it off the memory card, load, and also load and print. We are looking to print, so let's load and print. Look at the temperatures of the bed and the extruder, it's starting to go up. The bed heats up first, and once it hits 60 degrees centigrade, the extruder will start to heat up all the way to 200 degrees. Once the temperature is reached, the print starts. We have other tabs on the top. The control tab shows the webcam feed and also the printer controls, to move the extruder and the bed manually, and also to turn the fans on or off. I don't have the PiCam, so I don't get a video feed here. G-code view is a cool tab. It shows the current layer being printed. We can scrub forward and back and also up and down to see how the G-code or model data is being printed one layer at a time. We also have access to the Octoprint interface on the mobile phone, and all the features are also accessible here.
Octoprint opens up a plethora of information and granular control of your 3D printer. Being able to not only monitor but also control your printer from anywhere is a boon. I can now monitor the status of the print from office and also control the printer as required. Earlier, I had to remove the memory card from the printer, put it into your PC, copy the files across, and take it back to your printer and insert there, and then start the print. Now, by using Octoprint, I can now directly wirelessly upload a file and also start a print not only needing to be anywhere near the printer, but I can start to print from anywhere. For these features and the peace of mind it provides, I would totally recommend this augmentation to your 3D printer. So that's the video. Thank you for watching and see you all next time.
Make sure to like this video and also subscribe to the channel. Also make sure to click on the notification bell to be informed when new videos are added.